What's up, y'all? It's your boy Charles Griot. Listen, I found this video on Hollywood Unlocked. Shout out to Jason of Hollywood Unlocked. Just wanted to play this video. This is the Boot Girls. The Boot Girls are in Atlanta, and they help people with this whole boot thing that's going on in Atlanta. I'm gonna play the video. I'm gonna talk about it later.
But the Boot Girls are doing it.
All day, every day.
All day.
That's how often they say they're getting calls from drivers who have boots on their wheels in private lots in Atlanta, now that their videos on social media are starting to go viral.
And it is expanded out of nowhere.
The Boot Girls will swoop in and remove a boot from your car for a flat fee of $50. It's controversial because private parking lot companies own the boot and put it on there. The city of Atlanta allows them to charge you up to $75 a day every day the boot is on your car.
Predatory.
Christian Verrett is the one who started selling the keys that unlock Atlanta boots in the first place about a year ago.
It's holding someone hostage. You're holding somebody for ransom. $75 or you can't go anywhere. I'm not leaving my car in the middle of downtown.
Well, they'll say, but you shouldn't have parked illegally.
As opposed to, hey, a ticket. Put your ticket, walk away. You can just drive off with your ticket. And there's a video right now of a DoorDash.
Right.
Who parked for 2 seconds just to go grab an order. I mean, the guy's doing DoorDash. It was kind of a sad video. He was really emotional about he could not afford the seven. He just did not have it.
This week, he says he sold nearly $50,000 worth of keys. That's more than 300 orders. Atlanta police say it's not illegal to own one, but using it to unlock a private lot's boot could lead to charges like criminal trespass and theft of service.
I believe the police are stretching with that one.
The Boot Girls said they're not sharing their identity anytime soon.
We already have people that don't like us, so we'd rather just cover our identity anyway.
It may be risk, but the nice Boot Girls are doing
quick.
It.
All
on
day,
second.
Every day.
That's a nice little hustle they got going on. Man, they really are. Wow. So I've heard about this in Atlanta. This has been a big problem in Atlanta with the boots on the cars. This is something that they just started doing. It's just like in Orlando, Florida, where I'm from. They have a thing where those light tickets, those are private companies, and the fact that they can be able to do this. How are they able to operate like this? Anyway, what they do is they put those ticket lights on every corner in Orlando, Florida. And when you run those lights, of course, they take a picture of your license plate and everything. And then they send you a ticket in the mail. That money doesn't go to the city. It goes to the private company. They get a piece of what that private company makes from sending out the ticket. So it's not even owned by the city. It's like a corporation that does that, like a company that makes money that does that. Same thing with the boots in Atlanta. They put those boots on your car, and then you call that number, you pay them the $75. Maybe the city of Atlanta gets maybe what, 10, 15 bucks, and they keep the rest. So it's not even the city of Atlanta that's doing it. It's a corporation, it's a business. It's a bit, and a lot of times these lights, these boots, stuff that they're doing in Orlando, stuff that they're doing in Atlanta, they target urban people who can't afford to pay the $75 or whatever, how much the ticket costs, because they want you to not be able to pay it the first day. They want you because you ain't got the $75, and then they're going to charge you another $75. Then another. So now they got your car hostage, and each day you can't come up with that $75. You accumulating $75. That's like what homeboy was saying about the DoorDasher. You doing DoorDash, you doing bad. He probably makes $75 after working eight hours a day doing DoorDash. You see him? That's his take home after working 8 hours. You ain't making no money doing DoorDash. So when he said that the DoorDash dude was freaking out crying, yeah, because he know I can't afford the $75 today. And then tomorrow, when 12 o'clock hit, I ain't going to be able to afford the $75 tomorrow. So now I owe what? That's 150 bucks? I can't, you see what I'm saying? So then the next day it's going to be more. So it's like they target poor people, working class people with those camera lights. I noticed when they, in Orlando with the camera lights, it's in urban, it's in black areas. You know, it's mostly black and Puerto Ricans that are in Florida, but it's mostly in those areas. You go over to Kissimmee where Disney is, where all the rich celebration and Metro West, which is a very affluent area in Orlando, they ain't got those lights there. They ain't people who can't afford those things. They're not going to target them because those people's have those people in those affluent areas. They have high power lawyers. They have people on. You know what I'm saying? They have people that can fight. That can fight back. They know that the poor person, the DoorDash guy, he ain't got no power. He doing DoorDash. He can't even afford $75 for a damn boot, let alone fight anything. And that's what they know. You know, so it's all bleed the poor. That's what America is about now. It's about bleeding the poor. You know, leave the rich alone that can afford, but bleed the ride the back of the, you know, that's what all these companies, DoorDash, Uber, all those companies take advantage of, paying these little chump change money for rides and making deliveries. Cause they know if you coming to us to do this little chump change, get this little chump change for making deliveries, you need the money. So we're going to give you as less money as possible. So you can keep, it's the hamster wheel. You can keep running around, burning your gas, working yourself into the ground just to make $100. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, what do y'all think about the boot girls out of Atlanta? Y'all think this is admirable? You know, they made a little business, man. They probably gonna get arrested though, eventually. And they black, they ain't gonna let this slide. Homeboy made $50,000 selling the keys for $75. He was selling the boot keys. So if you got the boot in your car, you can just take it off yourself, which is smart. He made 50 grand. So, and these girls, instead of paying them 75, they charging people 50. So they undercutting. You know, whoever the private company is doing this scam shit. Anyway, what do y'all think about this video? Leave your comments and subscribe to The Griot. Y'all take care.